Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we learned about the superposition of two simple harmonic motion. Today, we are going to learn the vibrations in straight string. But before that, we must know harmonics and overtones. What are harmonics? What are overtones? And then we are moving towards the vibration in the straight string. So first of all, we learn about the harmonics. Harmonics means it is the fundamental frequency. What is fundamental frequency? The frequency in the simplest mode, or frequency of the fundamental mode. The fundamental frequency and all its integral multiples are combinedly called as harmonics. So what is harmonics? Harmonics means it is the fundamental frequency and all the integral multiples of fundamental frequencies are commonly known as harmonics. Okay, so this is harmonic. Now we are moving towards overtone. So if this n is a fundamental frequency, then this n, its second multiple, twice n, third multiple, 3n, up to the large number of integers. So we can write harmonic are nothing but the set of the fundamental frequency on and all its integral multiples. Now we are moving towards overtone. What are overtone? Overtone is nothing but the frequencies which are actually present in the vibration. The frequencies which are actually present in the vibrations are known as overtones. These overtones, they may be even, they may be odd, or all harmonics may be overtones. So it is depend upon the type of vibration takes place. Therefore, overtone means they are the actual frequencies present in the vibration. So we can write this overtone as the actual frequencies present in vibration. Okay, so harmonic means it is the fundamental frequency that is denoted by n, and all its integral multiple, they combine called as harmonics. And what is overtone? Overtone means it is the actual frequencies which are present in the vibration, either the vibration in the air column or they are vibration in a stretch string. Okay, so these are two terms, they are very important. Now we are moving towards the vibration in straight string. Okay, we know that vibration, when the vibrations are takes place in a straight string, there are the formation of stationary waves. But which type of stationary waves are formed? The stationary waves formed are transverse type. So we are using here the formula for the transverse waves. Okay, so what is the velocity of transverse wave? The velocity of transverse wave is given by v is equal to under root t divided by m, where this t is the tension and this m is the mass per unit length of the string. Okay, so this is the velocity of sound, or velocity of transverse wave in a medium, which is equal to under root t by m, where this t is the tension and this m is the linear density, linear mass density. Okay, now how the vibrations of string takes place? So we are going to learn about the first mode of vibration. First mode of vibration of air column. So consider that this is a string stretched between two rigid supports. Okay, consider that the length of this string is equal to L. Now, suppose that the mass of this string is equal to M, capital M. Okay, so we can write here the mass of string is capital M. So we can write this small m, that is mass per unit length, is equal to this capital M divided by L, that is mass per unit length. Now, how the vibrations takes place? This is the simplest mode of vibration of the string. When we plug this string, which is fixed between the two rigid supports, then there is a formation of wave like this. This is the incident wave, and then this is the reflected wave. So there is a formation of a loop, in which two nodes are formed at the rigid supports, and an antinode is formed in the middle of the string. So two nodes and a single antinode is developed in the first mode of vibration of the string. Now we know that, we already stated that the length of the string is equal to L, and we also know that according to the property of the stationary wave or the standing wave, the distance between two successive nodes is equal to lambda by 2. Okay, so we can write here this L length must be equal to lambda divided by 2, or we can write here this lambda is equal to twice of L. Now we know what is the velocity of sound. This velocity is given by V is equal to N multiplied by lambda, or we can write this N frequency is equal to, this frequency is equal to V upon lambda, but we can write this as this 1 by lambda multiplied by V. So lambda is equal to twice L, so we can write here is 1 upon twice L under root this t divided by m, velocity of the stationary wave. So this is transverse wave. It is n is equal to 1 upon twice L under root t by m. This n, we know that it is called as the fundamental frequency. This n, it is called as the fundamental frequency. Which is also known as first harmonic, because it is the first multiple of fundamental frequency. So it is called as a fundamental frequency because this mode of vibration is the fundamental mode of vibration, and it is also known as a first harmonic as it is the first multiple of the fundamental frequency. Now we are moving towards the second mode of vibration. How the second mode of vibration takes place? So this is a string having length L and having mass M, and small n is equal to M by L will remain constant. Now, here in the fundamental mode, we plug the string at one place in the middle. Now here we are plug the string at two places. So we get a structure like this. So here this node,
and here antitudes.
So in the second mode of vibration, which is higher than the first mode of vibration, three nodes and two antinodes are formed. As we know, this L is the length of this string, and we also know the length between two successive nodes from this node to this node. It is equal to lambda by 2, and this is also equal to lambda by 2. So the total of these two we get, it is equal to lambda. But as we denote lambda in the first mode of vibration, we denote differently by lambda 1 in the first second mode of vibration. So this lambda 1 is equal to, or lambda 1 is equal to L. That is the length on the string. Now again, velocity V is equal to, now it is L1 multiplied by lambda 1. Because this value remains constant, this value goes on changing. Now, listen, this L1 is equal to V upon lambda 1, which is equal to 1 by lambda 1 multiplied by V, which is equal to, what is lambda 1 is equal to, it is equal to L, and is multiplied by under root E upon M. Now, this is the frequency which is actually present in the vibration, therefore it is called as the overtone. So this L1 is nothing but the first overtone of the string. But if we divide and multiply by 2, this is 2 into 1 upon twice L under root T by M, this is equal to L1. So what is this? This is nothing but 2 multiplied by N, because 1 upon twice L under T by N is equal to N. So we can write here this N1 is equal to twice N. So what is this? This is the first overtone. And this first overtone is equal to second harmonic. So in this way, as the mode of vibration of the string increases, there are the formation of overtones and harmonic. If we derive a basic relation for the vibration of string between overtone and harmonic, so we can write here this Np is equal to P plus 1 multiplied by N. So this is the relation between harmonic and overtone. If we keep here P is equal to 1, where the values of P is equal to 1, 2, 3, 6. So if P is equal to 1, then it is equal to twice N. So N1 is equal to twice N. If we keep P is equal to 2, then it is equal to 3N. So like that, as the vibrations go on increasing, that is the mode of vibration goes on increasing, their relation is given by this general equation, in which this P denote the number of overtone and this P plus denote the number of harmonic present in the vibration. So in this way, today we discuss about the mode of vibration of string, vibrating string, and in the next lecture we are going to see the laws of vibrating string. So this is enough for today. Have a good day. Bye.